Guys, so this is the popular Lekki expressway. So we are showing only from the Aja side, side that goes to Langba Sabaduri, Aja side, then train Abamadisonya down to Eleko to Ekpe side. Alright, so but for the purpose of this video, and not only discuss in this video, I'll be focusing solely here, just between the Eleko junction, foundry is here, seaport is here, airport is here, to the Ekpe side. This is the Ekpe bridge here over the lagoon. So this is the lagoon here, this is the lagoon, while is the Atlantic Ocean here. Alright, so for the purpose of what I want to discuss, we'll be focusing around more of like the airport side, because most of the projects I'll be mentioning are around the airport axis. So let me zoom in here more. Alright, so now last year we had a particular project launched around the airport axis, and that's Itunu Residential. Itunu Residential is located somewhere around here. This, so Itunu Residential was launched last year, first quarter of last year, at 16.5 million. And Veritasi started a particular new tactics, new strategy, which is they told us the price of Itunu Residential at the pre-launch, and then they showed the charts, a kind of timetable showing us what price of Itunu Residential will be in 6 months time, or the price of Itunu Residential will be in 3 months time, in 6 months time, in 9 months time, in 1 year time, in 2 years time, and in 2 years time. So and a lot of investors bought into the project, specifically looking at what the appreciation would be in 1 year, in 2 years time, and then looking at it that okay, I can put my money here, and then in a couple of months I can get like 100%, 150%, and so on. Now there are some people that we call speculators. Speculators are people that go into a particular investment channel majorly for short-term gains. We have speculators in crypto, we have speculators in stock, we have speculators in real estate. Every form of investment have speculators, and in every investment, the people that get their hands burnt most times are speculators, because these are the people that they look at the charts, they look at the graph, and they look at it that okay, if I put my money there within so period of time, money can double and I can cash out. So and then unfortunately they put their money, the market crash. So a lot of speculators have started looking at this airport axis for a couple of months now, specifically because of how it is residential and its city are fed. And they're looking at it that okay, I can do this location, put buy 3 plots, buy 2 plots, cash out at 100%, 80% return on investment, very good deal. Now, don't be a speculator, and this is why, and I'll be showing you the reason why I'm saying this. Now, so after around 9 months, the price of Itunu Residential went up from 16.5 million to around 35 million. This is the price Itunu Residential was closed at. Now, at the time this property was 35 million, something happened. Now, a couple of people have invested in this location specifically for targeting where this property would be 35 million. But something shocking happened at 35 million. Let me zoom this location more, because I'll be talking about a lot of things. So, something interesting happened at 35 million. Now, within a couple of weeks after Itunu Residential hit 35 million, Veritasi came here, came around here, and launched Itunu City. They launched Itunu City. And equally around same time, we also had this project here just beside Itunu City. We had this project, we had the Imen Estate Phase 3, Imen 3, just beside Itunu City. And these projects are all around walkable distance to the Itunu Residential. The Itunu City was launched at 20 million. Imen Phase 3 then was even like 15 million. And what happened is that realtors moved from shouting Itunu Residential to shouting Itunu City. And what was trending all over at that period of time became Itunu City. And the same strategy is what Veritasi still came up. They still came up with another table that within so month time, the price of Itunu City will go up from 20 million to 35 million and then in a couple of years or a couple of months to 48 million, 60 million and so on. And what the speculators did again, speculators went there again and buy in bulk because they're looking at it that, okay, yeah, they did it with residential, I missed out, I don't want to miss out of this new city, and I can buy this property. The company say in 6 months time it's going to be 35 million. That means in 6 months time I can even sell because my 20 million have become 35 million and I sell at 30 million. So we have people taking speculators thinking that, okay, let me just buy, the pounds is at advantage, dollars is at advantage, let me just buy 6 months, 5 months when the company is selling at 35 million. I can just put my own in the market for 30 million. And we also have speculators also thinking that okay, in 1 year time it will move from 20 million to 48 million, and that means I can even obtain a loan and just walk up to a bank, obtain a loan of 20 million, maybe 18% interest or 10% interest. In 1 year, I pay back the bank 22 million or 23 million or 24 million, while I sell the property for like maybe 30 million or 32 million, and I just cash out on 3 million. Now, don't be a speculator. Don't be a speculator. And the reason is because this location, this entire location that you are looking here, this entire location is just starting. And as long as there are still options along this express, that are still selling, it will continue to crash whatever price all this Itunu residential or Itunu city are, regardless of the development that is there. A lot of people will look at it that why should I buy Itunu residential at 35 million or Itunu city at whatever price that it is right now, when Amen is beside it that is 18 million, when there is Hilton Garden along this route at maybe 25 million or 10 million or 15 million, when there is Tiwa. Tiwa also was launched recently. Tiwa is somewhere around here. Tiwa is somewhere around here, and Tiwa just launched at 19 million. And what I expected is within 2 weeks or 3 weeks, Tiwa sold around 93 plots. 93 plots was sold in Tiwa within 3 weeks because it was pre-launch, it's 19 million, the new city just a couple of minutes away is 26 million or whatever, and Tiwa is 19 million all inclusive. So a lot of people moved. So people will continue to move to all the options that are facing this expressway. As long as there is a new option here, it will be crashing whatever price Itunu residential is selling or whatever price Itunu city is selling. So again, speculators are always going to get their hands burnt. And this same thing also happened around mid last year. Let me just put it here. This may not be the right location, but let me just put it here. This also happened in Isimi too last year. Landwey also did the same thing when they announced that the price of Isimi will be moving from 30 million for or 37 million or 35 million for 1,000 square meters to around like maybe 100 million or 150 million. And a lot of people went there and just buy Isimi. So people bought 2 plus, or people bought 5 plus, or people buy 3 plus. A lot of people bought just because of that reason, that the price is moving within 2 weeks or 3 weeks from 30 million to 150 million. This is not investing, this is speculating. You are just speculating. Nobody are asking why is the price increase. Nobody is asking is there any developmental change in that location to warrant that price increase. Is there any change in demand in real estate in that location to warrant that price increase? People just go that my investment is moving from 30 million to 150 million and they just go there and buy. And right now, none of them that bought at 30 million last year or 35 million or 37 million right last year can even sell whatever plot they have in Isimi at 50 million. Nobody has even been allocated. So don't speculate, don't buy real estate for short-term gains. It's fine, the property are definitely going to appreciate. You can always look at the charts. Okay, it's going to become so amount in 5 months time, it's going to become so amount in 10 months time or in 12 months time. All those are simply strategies for you to buy, because they know that if they don't put it there, you investors will not buy, you will not act fast. So, but it doesn't mean that your investment or your money, your capital, have moved from 20 million to whatever million it is in 12 months time. Real estate is not money doubling, it's not a Ponzi scheme. So real estate is demand based, and there must be something pushing that demand for people to be able to pay you that price that you are putting on it. So basically, all the properties that we have around this area, around this location, around this axis, specifically all the properties that we have around these axes, if all this land facing the express are not exhausted, you can't cash out. As long as a new option is coming either before Imen, in between Imen, after Tiwa, in between Tiwa, before Itunu City, in between Itunu City, it will continue crashing the price of the existing ones. So if you want to cash out of this location, the maturity, the number one maturity is everything facing the express. Every estate facing the express have to be exhausted. So that's 2 to 3 years time. Then this airport also has to start. If this airport does not start, you can't cash out of this location. So that's why I said don't speculate. Don't speculate. Invest into this location. But again, you have to look at the demand in this location. Look at what is driving this demand before you now put it that, okay, yeah, let me invest.